Hi there! Need to learn how to unhide columns in Excel? Let me help. Hey, I'm Sharyn from Excel at Work, where we offer straightforward, non-technical assistance to help you save time, work smarter, and improve your Microsoft Office skills. If you're new here, make sure you click that subscribe button, and all the links to everything I mentioned in this video, you can find linked in the description box below. So, let's get to unhiding these columns. There are different methods depending on the version of Excel you are using. I'll take you through the method that will work on any version, then I'll quickly cover what's on offer in the newer versions, and then I'll take you through how to unhide column A or row 1, which is a bit tricky. So stick with me and I'll show you a tip on how to get them back. And once I've helped you master unhiding columns, to help you even more, I'll share with you a link to where you can grab our free self-assessment tool, where you can gauge your current skill level in Excel and create your own personal learning plan to help you fill in any gaps. Right, let's talk about unhiding columns. Now, hiding columns is actually quite easy. I'm just going to go up and select using my black arrow right at the top here in the column letter area. I'm just going to select over B and C, then right click on my mouse and going down to hide. And now I have hidden columns B and C. And that's a great thing to do. If you've got a really big worksheet and you've got a lot of information in there that you don't want to look at, you need to keep it, but it's just in the way. You can hide them. Great too if you don't want to print those columns as well. It's the getting them back that's a bit of a challenge. I'm just going to flick over here and hide these columns as well. So again, just a right click and then hide, and then you can actually see. Now, I just want to let you know that I am using Excel in my Office 365 subscription. So if you're in an older version of Excel, you may not be able to see these double lines up the top. I'm going to talk about them in a minute, but you'll definitely be able to see on your version of Excel where you do have hidden columns, because of course you will see that A to D, B and C are missing. So of course they are hidden. So let's talk about getting them back. Now, you may have tried to just go up to a column next door to where they're hidden and done a right click and gone unhide with no success. And that's what most people try and do. And it's a little bit scary when you're kind of like, you've hidden stuff and then you can't get it back again. So it's a really, really simple kind of move here. A lot of people may tell you just to go and select the entire worksheet up here. If you click on that little triangle up there and then just do a right click and then go unhide. But just a word of warning there. You know that I hid B and C and these columns over here. Every column will become unhidden if you do that. So if you're in a shared file with other people and you have just unhidden all of their work as well, they may not be that happy with you. So that's probably not my recommended way of doing it. It will work, but it will actually unhide everything. So I'm just going to do an undo. And of course we go back and now we're back to where we are. So if you do that, you can of course go and do the undo and get back to where you were previously. This is what I would recommend you do. Select the columns on either side of the hidden columns. Now do a right click unhide and look. So these ones are still hidden and these ones are back. So that is what you do. You select, I'll just show you that again. You select on either side of the hidden columns and then you unhide and you will get them back. That's really neat, isn't it? Now, if you're in a newer version of Excel like I am and you've got a really steady hand, you can try clicking and dragging on those double lines up the top there. And if you've got a really good hand, you might find that you can actually get them back. But I'm telling you now, if there's a lot of them, you'll be doing a lot of that clicking and dragging. So that might not be the greatest way to do it. But of course, you can do that if you want to. So that's fabulous, you know, when you're actually working just with randomly hidden columns, and the same for rows. So if I was to hide these rows down here and I just do a hide, and of course now you can see it's going from row 2 to row 5. So selecting on either side and then right click and then unhide and they come back again. So it's exactly the same. Now let's go across to a challenge that a lot of people come across, and that's where column A and row one are hidden, and you're trying to get them back, and you can't select on either side, can you? So you're kind of like, oh, that's a bit of a pickle. Now, again, you could definitely do the whole select and do the right click unhide. But of course, as soon as I do that, it will actually unhide this area over here, and that's not ideal. So this is a little trick. What you're going to do is you're going to use a shortcut key, your F5 key on the keyboard, function key 5 up on the top of your keyboard. If you press that, it brings up something called the go to dialog box. Now type in A1, which will take you to cell A1. Now, we can't actually even see cell A1 because row 1's hidden and column A is hidden. But as soon as we click onto that, it kind of looks like it shot up there. I don't know if you can see that on the screen. Now, once you're actually on A1, what you can do from the Home tab, you go over to Format and you go down to Hide and Unhide. Now, depending on what you're actually trying to unhide here, you could actually be unhiding the row or unhiding the column or both. So if I go unhide row, we've got row one back. Yay! So if I now go up and do it again, and we go down to unhide, and this time unhide columns, and look at that, you get it back. So that can actually be quite painful and quite hard to get to. So just remember that little shortcut key, you press your F5, you do your A1, and of course it will take you to the hidden cell A1, and then from there you can then just use your format, and then on the home tab obviously, and then the hide and unhide, and select the option that you need. So I really hope this instruction has been helpful and has you back on track. Just remember to select the columns or the rows on either side of what is hidden and then unhide. And for the first column or the first row, use the shortcut I showed you. Now, if you're really serious about improving your Excel skills and you'd love an idea of just what you need to know to become a more than proficient user of Excel, click the link on screen or the link below in the description box and grab your copy of our Steps to Becoming Proficient in Excel guide, a brilliant tool to use to assess your current skill level, identify gaps in your knowledge, and learn where to find the info you'll need to fill in any gaps that you have identified. Now, if this has been helpful, please hit the like button and please let me know in the comments below. And if you use Excel and want to stay connected, please make sure that you subscribe and hit the bell, because we're sharing new videos regularly. And if you know someone who would benefit from this help, please be sure to share this with them. Hey, thanks for watching and have a fabulous day.